This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to do a couple of basic examples of drug calculations that involve unit conversion. So here's the first problem. The order is for 7,200 milligrams. The tablets contain 6 grams. How many tablets should be given? So I'm going to set up my equation. The first thing I'll do is write the amount ordered. That's 7,200 milligrams. At the right side of the equation, I want to leave a space for my answer and the unit I'm going to have, which is the number of tablets, so tablets. Each tablet contains 6 grams, so I'm going to take that 7,200 milligrams and multiply it by the fraction 1 tablet over 6 grams. Now, notice I've got milligrams and grams, so I'm going to have to do some unit conversion. I'll make another fraction, and that's going to be 1 gram over 1,000 milligrams, since 1 gram is equal to 1,000 milligrams. And this is unnecessary, but I like to turn everything into a fraction, so I'll take that first number, 7,200 milligrams, and put it over 1. And now before I multiply, what I want to do is cancel out whatever units I can. So I can cancel out the milligrams. I've got milligrams in the numerator and the denominator. And I can cancel out the grams. I've got grams in the numerator and denominator. The only unit I'm left with is the tablets. And that's good because I want to end up with tablets. And now I'll see if I can simplify any of this. Well, I've got 1,000 in the denominator and 7,200 in the numerator. So I'm going to divide both of those numbers by 100. That just means crossing 2 zeros off of the end of each number. If I want to, I could simplify this even more. I could divide 72 by 6, and I could divide the 6 by 6. But you know, at a certain point, it doesn't matter if you simplify it completely, because you probably end up using a calculator and getting it down to a decimal. So let's just leave it at this and see what happens. I'll have 72 times 1 tab, so that's just 72. I've already got the tablets written in. And the denominator I'm going to end up with will be 6 times 10, so that's 60. I've got 72 over 60 tablets. If I put that into a calculator, what I'm going to find is that that equals 1.2 tablets. Now, since the decimal part, 0.2, is less than 0.5, that's the cutoff point for whether I'm rounding up or down, I'm just going to round this amount down, and I'm going to end up with 1 tablet as the dosage. Okay, so just to review this before we go on to the second one, I set this up like a basic problem. I started out with the ordered amount, multiplied that by the number, by a fraction, 1 tab over 6 grams, because a tablet contains 6 grams. And then since I had different units, milligrams and grams, I wrote another fraction which would allow me to convert between grams and milligrams. I canceled out all of the units that I could. I simplified as much as I felt like, multiplied across, and then took the fraction that I had left, and using a calculator, I would find out that that equaled 1.2 tablets. I would decide I could round that down, and that would get me down to 1 tablet. Okay, here's one involving micrograms. The order reads 500 micrograms. Scored tablets contain 1.2 milligram. How many tablets should be given? So we'll set this up just like the last one. The amount ordered is 500 micrograms. I'll put that over 1. I'll multiply by that by the fraction 1 tablet over 1.2 milligrams. Since I'm dealing with two different units, micrograms and milligrams, I'll have to have a conversion fraction. So I'll have 1 milligram over 1,000 micrograms, And my answer is going to be some number of tablets. Now I want to see if I can cancel out all the units except for the tablets. So I can cancel out micrograms over here from the numerator and the denominator. I can cancel out milligrams. I'm left with just tablets, and that's what I want to end up with. I can simplify the 500 and the 1,000. I'll just divide those by 100. And now I'm going to multiply across. I'll have five tablets, but I've got the tablets written in. 5 over 1.2 times 10 would just be 12. So I'll take that fraction, I'll put it into a calculator, and I find out that what that equals is 0.41666, and seems to go on, tablets. Now, it says these were scored tablets. So let's remember the rules for scored tablets. If it's between 0 and 0.24, in other words, if the decimal part that we have is between 0 and 0.24, we round down. If it's between 0.25 and 0.74, then we give a half a pill. If it's from 0.74 up to 0.99, then we give a whole pill. Well, the number we have, 0.41666, is between 0.25 and 0.74, so that means we're going to give one half pill, one half tablet. Okay, that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.